the champ, CCS champ. 2013, Deanne the champ, CCS champ. That's got to be our mentality going forward, right? It's got to be our mentality. We got 6 quarters left in the regular season, and then the fun begins. Who knows where against who knows who, or against who, okay? So let's play tonight out, play fast. You guys are flying around pretty good. When your number's called, get out there and fly around, okay? You just go to the wrong guy. Do it fast, do it physically, and do it as good sportsmen. You understand me? I don't know if there's any talking going on out there. Just celebrate with your teammates, keep your mouth shut, and keep making plays. All right, you got me? All right, let's finish this thing the right way.
Hi, my name is Mark Crail. I'm the head varsity football coach here at Los Gatos High, and I just finished year 9. Actually, year 34 overall for me coaching high school sports, but year 9 here at Los Gatos. A lot could be said about this team, obviously, you know, for the accomplishments that they put together and the run that they went on. You know, I think the record speaks for itself. We have a 10-0 regular season, undefeated league season, and championship. And, the thing that strikes me, though, most is the personality of the team and the guys on the team and the character of the young men that showed up every day to work hard and unbelievably selfless team in terms of being in it for the right reasons and being in it to represent their school and their town. So I think they accomplished great things on the field and super proud of them off the field as well.
These haters talk, but I don't give a got models, bottles, and the piff is lit, but we ballin'. Kinda like sprawlin' and rollin'. On the road to riches, never stallin'. Got your girl up all on my boy, she do it with joy, no almonds. Living life to perfection. VIP, that's the section. Presidential watch, presidential suites. You would think we held an election. Nick, go logic first, and I'm up next. I do not converse, I just cut checks. I do not rehearse, I just drop the verse. I need a cop of hers, cause I'm fresh to death. I bet you never seen so much designer. Never seen a with a that's finer. Boy, I stunt when I ain't even trying to. Swaggin' is nice, but first I'm a rhymer. And I rep Maryland, home of the Terrapins. Say you spit crack on me, we spit that heroin. Bring it right to your front door like I'm careless. Standing next to me would be so embarrassing. Yeah, we be ballin'. I came from nothing to something like it's nothing.
My name is Quinn Merritt. I'm number 1. I've been playing for about 4 years now. I'm a senior, and I'm a corner and a wide receiver.
I'm Jake Ripp. I'm a senior, number 9. I play linebacker and tight end, and I've been playing for 5 years.
Will Dal Porto, senior, number 4, corner, and I've been playing football for 4 years.
I'm Luke Pidog, class of 2022. I'm a senior wide receiver, and I'm number 13.
My name is Ben Agrado. I'm a senior. I'm number 44, and I've been playing football for 6 years.
Hi, my name is Luke White. I'm number 48. I'm a senior, and I play tight end, fullback, strong safety, and outside linebacker. And I've been playing football for 4 years.
My favorite play was probably my interception against Liberty. My boy Luke White tipped it up. I came down with it and changed the momentum.
I would say Liberty. It was our second game, and we were not expected to win, and they're a really good team. We were down at half, and they were chanting FLG, and we came back to win the game, which was awesome.
Before our Half Moon Bay game, it was our first home game, and just the feeling inside the locker room was crazy, and it's kind of one of the reasons why I love football. Just everyone was hyped, and everyone was ready to go out and just play football.
My memorable play was my touchdown versus Bell, because no team had the momentum yet, and we were on a risky play on fourth down, and we were able to score a touchdown from it.
Our first game got canceled due to the weather, due to the fires, and you know, we thought we were gonna go home and not have a game. At about 12 that night, we found out we were having a game the next day against a really good team. We went out, we balled out down in Santa Cruz, and we took the dub.
Our senior night against Mountain View, we opened up with a pretty long passing touchdown to me and a really good ball from Jake Boyd. And then we just lit them up from there. We really opened the floodgates. I don't know how many touchdowns it was, but something like 4 or 5 in the first 8 plays. So that was a really memorable night.
Yeah, you know, it's hard to pinpoint one, but I would think, well, I'm going to give you 2. The night of the Oak Grove game, when we were here, we were, you know, warmed up, ready to go, and all of a sudden the game was kind of pulled out from under us. And in the wee hours of the night, we found a game and ended up playing the next day against a really good Monterey Trail team who went to their section finals and ended up having a great season. And we won that game.
And then the next week we traveled, you know, a pretty good bus ride up to Brentwood and played Liberty and found ourselves trailing at halftime and really put together a, you know, a great second half. And that really kind of was a preview of what this team was going to be throughout the year.
Ethan Curry, class of 2023. I play middle linebacker and fullback, and I've been playing football for about 5 years.
I'm Landon Hurd, junior, number 5, safety, and I've been playing football for like 5 years.
I'm Richard Papapietro, number 72. I played O-line, D-line, and I've been playing football for 4 years.
I'm Caspian Bailey, I'm a senior, number 28. I'm a fullback, and I've been playing football for 13 years.
I'm Andrew Rogers, I'm a senior, number 20. I play fullback, linebacker, and D-tackle, and I've been playing for 4 years now.
I think like my most memorable memories were probably getting pancakes with Jay Gritt. That was fun.
Probably my pick six against Mountain View, like the 99-yard one, or my pick six against Wilcox. But yeah, most memorable for sure.
I think my favorite game would have to be Mountain View, where my brother got a pick six as a D tackle, and then to finish up the game, I got the last touchdown.
One memorable game was the Wilcox game. We were down by 3 because they got a lucky field goal in the beginning, but we soon picked it up and came back to beat them off our field. It was a very personal game for many of us because we lost to them our sophomore year, and so it was just nice to beat them on the last year of our high school career, send them home.
I think I knew we were going to be special when we beat Liberty and we came back that second half and really rallied together, and I felt like that was kind of the start of something special, so that was my favorite memory from this year.
The best thing about traveling on the road was the time we got to spend together and just trading laughs and telling stories.
My name is Brady Collins. I'm a senior, number 22. I'm a running back and I've been playing football for 6 years.
I'm Jalen Thomas, I wear number 32. I play free safety and wide receiver. I've been playing football for about 7 years and I'm a sophomore.
My name is Lucci Casale. I'm a junior. My number is 14. I play defensive end and outside linebacker, and I've been playing for 8 years.
I am Emiliano Mejia. I'm a junior. I play running back. I'm number 7, and I've been playing football for 7 years now.
I'm Sam Yelp, number 83. I'm a senior. I play defensive end and tight end, and I've been playing football for 5 years.
My name is Tate Schweitzer. I'm a senior. I'm number 86. I'm a defensive end. I've been playing football for 8 years.
I'm Olin Bernhoff, number 80. I'm a senior. I kick, and I've been playing football for 4 years now.
The most memorable game this season is probably the first home game. So I had a touchdown that game, and we had a crazy student section.
I'd say my pick six against Santa Clara. It was just all around a team effort. As soon as I caught the ball, everyone turned around just to go block someone to help me score that touchdown.
When we were playing Wilcox and we were on defense, Jack Saul forced a fumble, and Landon recovered it, and there was a photo that was taken, and in film room we saw it, and there was like 10 of our jerseys around the ball and like one of Homestead's jerseys around the ball, and that just shows like how fast our defense played.
Probably after the wins, we'd just be jamming to music together, so yeah.
In our last game, we ran a fake punt like on our 40-yard line, and like that was something cool to be a part of because it worked out and it was super cool, but we didn't win that game, but it was still fun.
My most memorable moment this year would be when we were playing Wilcox and it was nearing the end of the first half, and then we got to fourth down and I went out to long snap and I long snapped it to the wrong person.
Most memorable was probably the Wilcox game when it was still close and Landon got the pick six to seal the game, and I remember a bunch of us just ran down the sideline and then we greeted him on the field. I'm honestly surprised we didn't get a flag.
The most memorable play of the season for me was scoring against Bellarmine. That touchdown, it really, I think, set the tone for the game and proved that we can play with all the Catholic teams, and I think we still can.
At Los Gatos High School since 2008, and I've been coaching Los Gatos football since 2009.
I'm Alejandro Quijada. I'm a senior. I'm a six back, number 85. I've been football for 5 years.
My name is Jack Saul. I'm a senior, number 81, outside linebacker, and I've been playing football for 4 years.
My name is Andrew Thompson. I'm a junior, number 57. I've been playing for 6 years, and I play left tackle.
My name is Trent Steiner, number 11. I'm a senior. I play tight end and defensive end, and this is my 6th year of playing football.
My name is Yuma Romoriwaki. I am a senior. My jersey number was number 17, and I played wide receiver. I played football for 4 years now.
My name is Nicholas Ramos. I'm a junior. I'm number 51, and I play defensive tackle and defensive line, and I've been playing for 10 years now.
My name is Jake Boyd. I'm number 12, and I play quarterback. I'm a junior, and I've been playing football for 5 years.
I'm Spencer Berg. I'm a sophomore. I'm number 18. I play middle linebacker and fullback, and I've been playing football for 4 years.
The most memorable play of this season, I feel like, was when Kevin scooped up an interception and scored for the pick six when we were playing against Half Moon Bay.
Against, I think it was Santa Clara that we played. And I wasn't in this play, but it was when Yuma got a kickoff, or no, a punt, and he trucked like six dudes and ended up scoring. But they called it back because some stupid penalty that shouldn't have been called. But the whole sideline was going crazy, and it was just kind of a cool like moment for the team.
Easily the Bellarmine game. Coach called 69 fly pass, and I think we called Quinn as a touchdown. Easily the most memorable moment.
The fake punt we got for a touchdown against Bellarmine was definitely an awesome play.
Definitely the most memorable moments for me were pancakes I had during Mountain View or Milpitas. It'd be a go against this guy on Milpitas, number 7. He kicked my ass a couple plays, and then I remember one play, I draw him upfield, and I just turned my shoulders and flipped him, and next thing I know, I was on top of him. There's nothing more rewarding than that.
A great moment this season was either beating Wilcox, because that's always a great team to play, or either going 10-0, because that's a great accomplishment.
Probably the most memorable moment this year for me was scoring my first touchdown at a home game against Half Moon Bay. And I could just remember the student section going crazy, and that was probably the most excitement I felt in my life.
I would say my most memorable play was against Milpitas. It was on kickoff. I had a forced fumble and my teammates jumped on it. I feel like it really turned the game around for the better.
I mean, overall, I think obviously given, you know, everything going on in the world and in our small little world, this was an extremely successful season. And I think, You know, it's easy to talk about plays and games and specific moments, which I look forward to seeing these guys down the road when they're all grown up and have families of their own and lives of their own, and we can reminisce about, you know, big moments. But I think, you know, most importantly and most significant are all the small moments that happen in practice, the things that people don't really get to see. Those are much more meaningful, I think, in the end, creating what's most important about our experience rather than in games. I think there's innumerable examples. Walk out to the practice field and, you know, I could be talking about interest rates with Olin, or checking in on a kid that I never actually coach because they only play offense, seeing how their day is going, talking to kids about, you know, what they're thinking about for college or their future. And I think this group was really just fun to be around because you could feel how much they liked the activity and, more importantly, how much they enjoyed being around each other. I think one of the moments from practice that stands out is all the way at the end of the season, which, if you consider the COVID season and all the practice we did leading up to it and then all the practice that happened after that 5-game season, man, we were together just an awful lot. And you know, we're at the end of the season, so it's like week 15 of practice. We're doing a tackling drill, which, you know, is hard.
I just, again, would say how proud I am of these guys and how they went about their business. You know, we had 10 weeks in a row where we walked off the field as victors, and, you know, it was a crushing defeat that last game of the year, and I replay that game in my mind 1,000 times already, and you know, obviously we wish it went differently, but the atmosphere that night was fantastic, and sadly one team had to, you know, call it a season because of the loss, but I think this team is just going to be ranking up there amongst some of my favorite teams that I've coached, and the accomplishments that they had were tremendous.
Thank you, Coach, for believing in me and a great 10-0 season.
I'd definitely like to thank the coaches for giving me a chance. I was injured last year, so didn't really know what they were getting into with me, especially to Coach Clark for believing in me to be able to make plays. Overall, it's been a great journey, so the coaches really made it possible.
Thank you, Coach, for always pushing me to be my very best. You pushed me on the field to be the better fullback, and you pushed me off the field to become a better person. Thank you.
Thank you for always looking out for us and putting us in a position to succeed.
I'd like to thank them for everything they've done for me. You know, I've learned so many things about life through football and through their coaching, so I really want to say thank you for everything they've done.
I would just like to say thank you for the great opportunity you gave me and also the team, putting us in better positions to make us better and try to dominate other teams.
I want to thank the coaches for providing such a great environment for us and really leading us to be the great team that we were.
I would just like to say thank you guys so much for devoting all your time and just putting in so much effort every day to make us better and make us the best team that we can be.
Yeah, I just want to thank the coaches for always trying to make us better and turn us into better players and better people.
I would like to thank the coaches for helping me out with the playbook and just helping me become a better football player and the entire team and just supporting all of us and becoming a great football team.
I'd like to thank Coach Clark for just bringing all the energy every practice. I think that was a huge part of our success because we thrived off of that.
I'd like to thank Coach Carrillo for making the season so memorable and having so many moments in practice or in the games that are just awesome. Couldn't be any better. Best coach.
I want to say thank you for just every day pushing me to get better and pushing our team to get better. You know, and even if we had a bad day, just to continue to strive to get better every single day.
I would like to tell all the coaches thank you for helping me become the best football player I can be and for helping me become who I am today.
I just want to tell Coach Clark and Coach Crail how thankful I am for them both being great mentors and always pointing us all in the right direction.
I would just like to thank all the coaches for accepting me as a transfer student and just teaching me how to play Los Gatos football and just welcoming me as a Wildcat.
I want to thank the coaching staff for pushing me to work hard and be a better person on and off the field.
I'd like to tell the coaches thank you for supporting me and helping me grow and guide me along the path of becoming a better football player, and not just as a football player, but as a person and as a man. And you guys really helped me grow on and off the field, and I really appreciate that. Thank you for always pushing me to be the best player I can be on the field and also the best person I can be in general.
I'd like to first off thank Coach Clark and Coach YCO for pushing me to be the best defensive player I can be. I'd also like to thank Benny Grotto because he was always super energetic and hyping me up when I was tired and helping me push through the last rep of whatever we were doing.
I want to thank the coaches for all their time and effort they've put into this program to make it great.
I would just like to thank the coaches for everything they've done for me on and off the field for the past 4 years now.
I just want to thank the whole coaching staff for pushing me to work my hardest, and especially Coach Clark for mentoring me off the field especially, and for the great sideline conversations we had.
Thank you for helping me become the person I am on and off the field, and thank you for making this season super memorable.
How nice would it be to be 10-0? Yeah, no. Huh? It doesn't get any better than that.
My dad, my mom for always supporting me, coming to all my games and just being super excited to always go out. And I want to thank my dad for always pushing me and always just giving me that kind of extra push to become a better player, whether it was running back or nose tackle.
I'd like to thank both my parents for coming out to every single game and for my dad for taking a ton of pictures of me.
Yeah, I want to thank my mom and dad for always coming to my games and supporting me and my brother.
Thank you, Mom and Dad, for supporting me every game and coming every game. It means a lot.
I want to thank my Mom and Dad for supporting me throughout the season and coming to every game and always being there for me when I needed them.
I just want to thank my parents so much. My dad has been coaching me almost my whole life. My mom has been coming to every single one of my games, driving me to practice, driving me everywhere, just to be the best version of myself in football.
I just want to say thank you to my parents. Now, thank you for always believing in me, coming out to every sporting event, supporting me through everything. It really means a lot. Love you guys.
Thank you, Mom and Dad, for supporting me through this season and through life. I really appreciate it. Love you guys.
Thank you, Mom, for pushing me to be my very best, and thank you, Dad, for creating a pathway for me. Love you guys.
Mom and Dad, thank you so much for coming out to all my games and supporting me throughout all these years.
I would just like to thank my mom and sister for coming out to every game and just showing love.
I want to thank my mom and dad for pushing me to be the best athlete and student and just overall person every day. I really appreciate that.
Thank you, Mom and Dad, for giving me this opportunity to play. And I am very grateful for what you've done for me.
I'd like to thank my mom and dad for always pushing me to be the best athlete I could be on the field. Always taking me down to the field when I didn't feel like it working to make me the best player I could be.
I want to thank my mom and dad for always taking the time to come and support the team and me. I believe that this team was a big family, some people that I could go to and turn to whenever times got hard.
I just want to say thank you to my parents, my sister, and my grandparents for watching online even though they're like 3 hours away, but thank you.
I would like to thank my mom and dad for coming out to all my games and supporting me and watching it even when they couldn't be there. Thank you.
Thank you, Mom and Dad, for always coming out to my games and for always supporting my dreams of football. And just thank you. I would like to take this time to thank my whole family. Thank all of you guys for coming out, supporting me. It really means a lot. That really gets my energy and my blood flowing before the games and help me play better on game day.
Thanks, Mom, Dad, and Camille for always coming out, especially Blair and Conrad, and more importantly, for the food after the games.
Thank you, Mom and Dad, for coming out to all our games and supporting me throughout the season.
Yes, I want to thank my entire family, my grandpa, my siblings, and my parents for always going to all the games and always supporting me.
I would just like to thank my parents for being there every game, supporting me, cheering me on. My dad filming the games and watching me, sharing most of me on the field that I don't think could have shared from the stands.
Thank you guys for everything. It's been 6 years on this journey and couldn't have done it without you. So for all the help you've had, thank you.
I would just like to thank my mom for just making me pregame meals every single game and every single Thursday before games, just taking the time out of her day to make the best meal that she can. And I'd just like to thank my dad for encouraging me to play football, even at Los Gatos, where I thought I wouldn't be able to even start at.
To my mom and dad, and to the rest of my family, you guys were at every single football game, so I love you guys forever for that, and thank you so much for supporting me. I wouldn't trade the season for anything. You know, it ended how it ended, but we were 10-0, and it was a blast. Every single day was fun out there with my teammates. I loved practice, I loved the game, so I wouldn't trade it for anything.
10-0, baby, 10-0, let's get it, baby, let's get it.